We shall now estimate the number of bridges possible in a graph. Consider this graph, and in this there are no bridges. If you remove any edge, graph is still connected. No bridges. But this graph has an articulation point. This is an AP. If you remove this, then this part of the graph is disconnected from the rest. You look at path graph, and if you run DFS, this itself is our DFS tree. So this is a bridge because no back edge from any of the descendant to you. In this case, there is no ancestor. Similarly, this one is a bridge, this one is a bridge, this one is a bridge. In fact, if you take a tree, any tree on, say, so many vertices, say n vertices. So if we remove this, then this part of the tree is disconnected from the rest. If you remove this, this part of the tree is disconnected from the rest. In fact, all are bridges. So which means a tree on n vertices, a tree on n vertices has n minus 1 edges, and all edges are bridges. This means a graph can have a maximum of n minus 1 edges. And it is tight. And it is tight in the sense that the tree, any tree has got n minus 1 edges. So number of bridges in a graph is lower bounded by 0, upper bounded by n minus 1. Here is a graph which has n minus 1, and here is a graph which has no bridges. So, for an arbitrary graph, it is between 0 and n minus 1. Number of articulation points in a graph is between 0 and n minus 2. There are graphs where we have no articulation points. For example, this one has no AP, which means this bound is tight. N minus 2 is tight for path graphs. And this one is tight for PN. Okay. Then there is something called biconnected component or biconnected graph or biconnected graphs. So a graph is biconnected if it has no articulation points. A connected component is a biconnected component if there are no articulation points in the connected component. Let's look at an example to understand these definitions. Consider this graph. Let's take this kind biconnected component 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we take all vertices 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 along with all edges incident among this. Okay. Now this one is connected between any pair of vertices. You see there exists a path. That's one. And this one has no articulation points, which means this is a biconnected component. So let's look at 4, 6, 7. 4, 6, 7, same thing. No AP. If you just look at this connected component, it only says focus on a connected component. This connected component has no articulation points, implies it is biconnected. The similar line, let's look at 5891. So 5891, this is also a biconnected component. The similar line, let's look at 514, 13, 12, 11, 10, 8. This one is also a connected component, no articulation points in this. So this is also a biconnected component. And we can also add the other stuff as well, which means given a graph, if G has no APs, implies G is biconnected. If G has articulation points, then G can be decomposed into a collection of biconnected components. For example, this one is having AP, so which means the graph is not biconnected, but it can be decomposed into a collection of biconnected components. For example, we say 4, 6, 7 and the rest, and rest of the graph. So 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 9, 8, then you get 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, this. Even this can be further decomposed because each one is not having articulation point, but this is our biconnected component 1 and biconnected component number 2. When G is having an articulation point, then G can be decomposed into a collection of biconnected components. Or rather, if you focus on the articulation point, around the articulation point, you see that there are biconnected components. Let's look at one more example. Consider this graph. So in this graph, this one is an articulation point, this one is an articulation point, this one, this one, this one. So please note, just now we observed, this one is not biconnected, G is not biconnected, then G can be decomposed decomposition of G into biconnected components. So around articulation points we find that, so 1, 2, 3 is a biconnected component, and 1, 4, 5 is a biconnected component. And 5, 6, 7 is a biconnected component. So please note, each of this is maximal in nature, or maximal biconnected components. The sense that you cannot add any other vertex from the graph along with edges, or if you add any other vertex and see its induced subgraph, the graph is not biconnected. Meaning, for example, look at 5, on this side 6, 7, and if you add any other vertex along with the edges, for example 4, then this one is not a biconnected component because this one is an AP. And you cannot add any other vertex and still ensure it is biconnected. This side 4, you add say 1, then we see that this is still not biconnected. So which means each of this is maximal in nature. So I cannot add any more vertex along with the edges and still preserve the biconnected property. This one. Now if you look at 4 and 8, 4 and 8, if you see, if you remove 4, then we are left with 8, which is still connected. So which means 4 is not an articulation point. 8 is also not an articulation point. When we say articulation point, when we remove, we get at least two components. Correct? So, V belongs to AP if G minus V is disconnected. Or, G minus V has at least two connected components. But when we remove 4, we have just 1, which means it is still connected. When we remove 8, we have just 1, it is still connected. So 4, 8 has no articulation points. So this is also a biconnected component. In fact, these biconnected components are called trivial BCC. On the similar line, 8, 9 is an articulation point. Sorry, 8, 9 is a biconnected component because there are no bridges. 9, 10, yes, and subsequently we get 10, 11, and 12. Please note 4, 8, 9. This one is not BCC because 8 is an articulation point. So which means 4, 8 is maximal in nature. 8, 9 is maximal in nature, 9, 10 is maximal in nature, 10, 11, 12 is maximal in nature. So if G is not biconnected, then G can be decomposed into collection of biconnected components. And some of them are non-trivial and some of them are trivial. Trivial are bridges. 4, 8 is a bridge, 8, 9 is a bridge, 9, 10 is a bridge. So which means any bridge is a trivial, any bridge is a trivial biconnected component. Because any bridge, if you look at just the bridge, it has no articulation point, it is satisfying the definition, so it becomes a biconnected component. Consider the path graph again. So we see that this one is a biconnected component. This one is a biconnected component. So there are four biconnected components, or rather, each bridge is a biconnected component. So for a given graph, number of biconnected components at the maximum n minus 1, the given graph itself is biconnected, so it is 1. Suppose given graph itself has no articulation points, so this one is BCC, so it is 1. If not, we have just now seen that it can be decomposed into a collection of biconnected components. So there are other interesting applications which we shall see as we look at other concepts. As far as time complexity is concerned, time complexity of DFS, so what we do is we start from a vertex and then start exploring its neighbor, like that we do it. When we cannot proceed any further, we backtrack and then we proceed in this. Then we cannot proceed, when we cannot proceed down, we backtrack. So this is how we do DFS. So as part of DFS, we see that all these vertices are visited and that cost is n. And if you look at the edge, we visit this edge when we go down, again when we backtrack. Similarly, this edge we visit when we move down, again when we backtrack, and no further visit. So each edge is visited at most 2 times. Fine. And which means there are m visits. N represents number of vertices and m represents number of edges. Which means time complexity of DFS is order of n plus m. Now once we get DFS tree, we can list all back edges. Then using back edges, we can do cycle testing, odd cycle, even cycle. Then using these structural properties, we can list articulation points, bridges, and biconnected components. So which means all these can be answered as an application of this. So all of this are solvable in polynomial time. So polynomial in input size. In this case, input size is n and m. N represents the number of vertices. M represents the number of edges. So using DFS, one can list all articulation points, bridges, biconnected components. And once we get DFS tree and back edges, these ideas are straightforward. And most importantly, we can solve all of them in polynomial time. In fact, we can get all of them in linear time as well. Which means in order n plus m time, we can list all articulation points, bridges, and biconnected components. Fine. So this is graph traversal. The output of this is a tree. And one can do interesting applications on that tree. That's precisely what we have seen. There are other graph algorithms like listing all spanning trees, finding a minimum spanning tree, and finding a spanning tree with some specific property. For example, minimum number of leaves, maximum number of leaves, and shortest path algorithms. So all that we shall see next.